Is that okay? It's probably big enough. That's what she said. Okay. Season 4 is coming to Warzone. I can't even believe how close we were to it, but it's closer than you think. I'm really only going to go through the Warzone updates. There's a whole bunch of multiplayer things as well here, but Warzone, June 16th, 9 p.m., so that's late my time. I'm going to be up on the 17th, and we're going to be streaming it on Thursday. Stay tuned for that. Groundfall event will also be starting. Note that this is an event. This is going to be a limited time event. So it's not necessarily going to be a separate limited time mode, which I think was what I initially thought when I read it. But there's these crash satellites you can go around. There are certain things you can get at the satellites as well, though. So there's going to be items in game, and we'll see some of that later on here. Of course, there's some new operators as well. They're looking very clean, although, you know, maybe a little hurt at the same time. A lot of multiplayer news, but we also did get some new weapon information as well. The MG82 is going to be out of the game. The highest fire rate, which is similar to the other LMG that's in the game, MG34. This is also super high fire rate LMG that's in the game, but this is going to have improved aiming speed as well, moderate recoil, moderate, you know, with increased ammo capacity as well. So we'll see. Obviously, usually the LMGs are hindered by the actual movement speed as well. But if it's got a fast aim down sight, fast fire rate, it could be very interesting. Although I recently been trying the Finn, and that one was pretty interesting too. So maybe it even competes with something like that. I'm not so sure. The next gun here is the assault rifle, the C58. Oh, by the way, this one's going to be from tier 15. This one from tier 31. This is going to be an assault rifle, high damage at close range with a slower fire rate, less ammo capacity as well. This makes me think of like the SCAR, which nobody really likes anyway. So maybe this would be like a SCAR that's actually fun to use. I don't know. They're going with less ammo capacity for a lot of these. I don't know if the attachments will make it bigger and easier to use, but that's something you'll see later on as well. The nail gun is also being added. Slow firing, high mobility power tool. What's interesting is it does mention high mobility. So maybe this is something which we have seen some of the Cold War guns being built where you can actually run faster than the train, for example. Maybe this is something where you run even faster than what like normal running speed is, and that's the benefit from it. It's like a super quick rotating special weapon that you could use. I don't know. After 3 successful hits within a few meters in multiplayer is something that it mentioned. That's how it takes 3 shots in multiplayer to kill somebody. So my understanding is that it probably would be about 34 damage per shot. Maybe you do it faster if it's a headshot. I guess we don't know the rate of fire for it as well, but it doesn't seem like it's going to be crazy powerful in terms of the damage, and I can't imagine the magazine's going to be too big. So I think this is really going to be just like a specialty challenge type gun. And then they're also adding an SMG. This is going to be an in-season reward that's going to be added later on. Stopping power and phenomenal fire rate, it mentions. So it's going to be super fast fire rate, but a 20-round magazine. This just makes it so I think it's going to be good for multiplayer. I can't imagine it's going to be too effective, honestly, for Warzone with such a small magazine. It's going to be such a big limitation for the gun. But, you know, who knows? Some people like some of those guns, and they're all crazy. Then there's the mace, which is a melee weapon. Sometimes they add these to the game. You can check that out, too. It's going to probably act the same for all of those ones. Obviously, a ton of multiplayer updates. We're not going to read through all of these, but new maps. This was kind of interesting. They're adding the multi-team Satlink mode, which we played. If you guys saw, I did a video on multi-team, or it was basically Warzone inside of the Battle Royale, or excuse me, it was basically a Battle Royale inside of Call of Duty, Black Ops, Cold War, but it wasn't called the Battle Royale. It was just called Elimination, and it was a multi-team thing. This is, I guess, kind of similar. It's going to be 10 squads all playing on, you need to go capture objectives. This was super interesting too. You guys remember the red doors from the first season update, or from the earlier season update that we had? The red doors are actually going to be here. Our intel cannot explain the origin of these mysterious red doors around Verdansk, but one thing is certain. They allow you to, redacted, around the redacted. Once behind them, explore and enter them to redacted across the redacted. Red doors won't redacted unless you ping them, and after you step through them, there's no telling redacted exiting out the other side and stepping into a redacted. So based off of this, as well as the surveys that had gone out to some players that was a couple month, you know, month or whatever or so ago, they were asked, how did you like the season? And some of the questions were, what did you think of the red door teleportation system that was on, that was implemented? But there was no red door teleportation system. Well, it's looking that like that might be the case now, where you can use this as a way to traverse the map. Similar to what we saw even with the underground railroad or the subway system that was in the game that you could basically teleport to other sides of the map. You didn't actually ride it the whole time. You kind of went through and then it would go all black and then you would all of a sudden appear somewhere across the map. It was kind of like that, but now there's going to be more just like straight up, probably a straight up just teleportation system to move across the map. I'll keep you posted on anything with this. Obviously, in a couple days, we're going to be getting this, as well as we will have the full patch notes with all of the different gun and weapon changes. I'll keep you updated on all that. Make sure you are following the page. Give it a little like, maybe, if you're down for it. And I'll keep you posted on it, all right? That was the big thing. Obviously, they're also changing the Gulag to Hijacked for the launch of this. The boat map, that was an old Black Ops map. It's going to be the very middle of that, where there's the flag and the jacuzzi over here. Now, this is what I'm hyped for, my guys. The dirt bike is being added to the game, and we got some details with it. Excellent turning radius. Carry yourself and a companion so you can carry others. Go up trails, down rock fills with ease. So maybe this will let us get up and down hills even easier than even vaulting them, because the climbing system is so broken in this game. I don't know. Probably not, but I'll, you know. Dirt bikes will have some unique handling properties, such as wheel traction, sliding, drifting, and vehicle leaning, allowing you to take epic hairpin turns, dodge oncoming fire, and most importantly, pull off six stunts by controlling your orientation in air. I don't know if you guys ever played PUBG, but doing backflips and riding on the dirt bikes in that game was 26.9% of the fun. I would just drive around on the motorbike, and if you fell in that game, you would die. I don't know if it's going to be the case in this game, but that is going to be epic. In addition, all dirt bike skins you may unlock in Black Ops Cold War, previous battle passes or store bundles will be accessible, allowing you to customize them. So if we've already got some dirt bikes from Cold War, we'll be able to customize some of that. So that's kind of nice as well. Downtown is also here to stay, which I was pretty surprised by. They said this was just going to be a limited time thing, but the downtown tower plaza under new management is here to stay. I was really surprised by this. Expect the meta tactics you learned during the 80s action hero events to come in handy here too. And it also mentions that the doors are going to be open, the vault's going to be open, so there might be some more loot in there. It probably won't be as crazy, but I don't know what they're talking about with this, where some of your tactics. Are they just, I don't know if they're trying to hint at something here, that there maybe is going to be some new features or something else that we could still do there, like maybe the underground killing the juggernaut is still going to be there. I don't know. They're also adding two new game modes across Verdansk, which I thought was really interesting here. Verdansk Resurgence Mini Royale. So we saw Resurgence in Verdansk, and that was overall very well-liked, but they're going to be adding it as Resurgence Mini Royale. So you're going to already start in Zone 2. It's going to be much smaller. It mentions 44 to 45 operators is a maximum for it. It's going to be compact zone. And they also mentioned solos here, which I was very surprised by, because Resurgence doesn't do anything in solos. That means that your team is still alive and they respawn you because you're still alive. They respawn off of you. But in solos, that wouldn't do anything. So I don't know how that's mentioned here, but yeah, solos, duos, trios, and quads. I don't know if they're just talking about solos for just regular mini royales or if the people that wrote this don't play the game, which very well could be the case, because I think it's just a lot of interns working at the company right now. I don't know. It's a small indie developer company. They're still working on things like anti-cheat and stuff because they're a very small company, brand new to the space here. So the final mode here that they mentioned was Payload, which was interesting, coming mid-season. And this one, it's going to take a little bit of dissecting here, but it's an objective-based game mode. You and 39 other operators escort two caravans to checkpoints or sabotage the missions. You can still pick up contracts, it mentions as well, but this was really interesting. You could build or destroy barriers and purchase buildings to aid in your squad's mission. It made me think, if you're escorting something similar to like Overwatch missions, which you would escort people, through on the hit squad. On the, you would literally stand next to a little cart and it would travel and you had to escort it through. It's going to be really interesting to see how this works, but they've tried a couple unique things in this game, including like the, you know, the one where you have an armored Royale, the armored truck Royale. Like, they've tried some different things, but this is not going to be a battle Royale mode. This is going to be them trying something different with it. So I'm interested to see how that works out. And then there's going to be the baseball bat too. But that was pretty much everything that I thought that was interesting in this one. Let me know what you guys think. And yeah, we'll go from there. Let's hop into some games. And oh, stay tuned. We're going to be doing a full breakdown like this for the actual details of the multiplayer when it comes out. MG34. This is also super high fire rate LMG that's in the game. But this is going to have improved aiming speed as well, moderate recoil.